Hey, what's up, you guys? Thanks for coming back to my channel. So today I'm going to be doing a dramatic eye. The first one I'm doing is starting off with my NYX primer, and I'm going to be putting that all over my lid. Next, what I'm doing is taking a sponge just to smooth the primer out. Even when you're gone, I think of you, boy. Then I'm going to be taking my Sasha Buttercup powder just to put that on top of the primer to set it. Now I'm taking my Morphe 35T palette and I'm taking that tannish color, it's more of a natural skin color. And then I'm going to be taking this darker purple and I'm going to be blending that into the crease of my eye. And that will be one of my transition colors, and I'm just going to blend it out as much as I can. Be the one that you lay with, be your favorite song on your playlist. Nothing ever fades like it's stainless. You're acting like you want to be Bayless. Next, I'm taking this darker brown color, and that's going to be my real transition shade because it's going to help me transition into my other dark color. So I'm going to be putting that into the crease of my eye as well, and I'm blending it out as best as I can. Next, I'm going to be taking this dark purple, which is more of, also have a dark brown undertone, and I'm going to be putting it on the outer corner of my eyes and sweeping it into the crease. I'm trying to give that smoky eye dramatic effect to a natural type of look. So next, what I'm going to be doing is taking a leftover concealer that I had from doing my eyebrows, and this is LA Girl's Pro Concealer in the color Warm Honey, and I'm going to be just taking it onto my lid. It's not a perfect cut crease, but it's as best as I can do. This is for beginners because I'm a beginner too with doing more dramatic makeup. So as I take that and I put that on both the lids of my eyes, I'm going to next be taking this shimmery brown shade from the same palette, and I'm going to be putting that on top of the lid of my eyes. So it won't be, so the concealer is light, but that brown will stick out a little bit more because the concealer is so light. So I went back into that transition color and I'm just putting that on top of the lid just to give it more definition. And then I'm going to be taking my light shimmery color to put that onto my brow bone to give it more of a light effect. And my kiss glue, my kiss lashes, and the name Hollywood. And I put those on and then I'm going right back into that transition shade again just to blend out if I got any glue anywhere. So next I'm going to be taking my e.l.f. primer and I'm putting it all over my face, especially my T-zone. And then I'm going to be taking my Maybelline Fit Me foundation in the color 355 Coconut. However, I usually use the matte, but this time I'm feeling like dewy smooth, so I use that as well. Which isn't too good with oily skin, however I have combination skin, so I try to work it out somehow. But I'm taking this brush that I got from Target. I'm going to link down below the name of the brush set. It's a really nice brush. I love it. I love it for my foundation. And I'm just going to be buffing my foundation into my skin. I used to believe we were burning on the edge of something beautiful. Something beautiful. We're selling a dream. So next I'm taking my LA Girl Pro Concealer in the color Warm Honey again, and I'm going to be highlighting underneath my eyes, down my nose, and on my chin, and a little on my forehead because I have a huge forehead. And next one, after I highlight, I'm going to be taking my Sasha Buttercup powder and I'm going to be setting those areas. After setting those areas, I'm going to be taking my Ruby Kisses Concept Palette in the darkest color. Obviously, see, I have been through it so fast. But I'm going to be contouring my forehead down my cheeks and a little on my nose. I didn't really contour my nose, but the look still turned out fine and I really do love it because it is a natural soft glow and it's not too harsh. And I don't really like to contour my nose sometimes because it gives me more of a stronger feature, like stronger masculine features, if that makes any type of sense. If it doesn't, ignore it. So now I'm going to be taking my mascara and putting on my lower lashes. I'm putting on my NYX finishing matte spray. I'm spraying my face with that. Then I'm going into my Ruby Kisses highlight palette. All those highlights broke in 2 days because they fell on the floor and it broke, but those were the only two that stayed together. I love them. I'm so happy. And I put that on my cheeks and my nose. Now I'm going in with my NYX liquid lingerie in the color Honeymoon. It's a matte lip. And now I'm taking my blush from the e.l.f. blush palette and I'm putting some onto my cheeks. Now I love me a matte lip, but I also love me a glossy lip. So this is my NYX gloss and you can put that on as well. You like glossy.
Let me love you.
Thank you guys for watching. Hopefully you enjoy. See you later. Bye.